team, the Rhinos Academy, are wary of the Sharks after recent meetings. Leeds' only defeat last year on their way to the Academy title was here at the Boulevard. So even though this season the Rhinos are third from top and Hull are third from bottom, Leeds can take nothing for granted. Hull Sharks line up with Jason Abdul at fullback, the wings Johnny Woodcock and Ian Bell, in the centres Craig Farrell and Darren Lilford. The halfbacks Luke Judson and Sean Cook. In the pack, Chris Traynor, Mark Moore, Carl Murray. Second rows, Craig Lawton, Martin Osler and loose forward Fazil Baluchi. On the bench for the Sharks, Steve Kelly, Chris Elliott, Craig Cook and Peter Kerr. For the Leeds Rhinos, Danny Cook is at full back. Mark Calderwood and Kirk Wisdom are the wings. Andy Kirk and Glenn Donkin in the centres. The halfbacks Matthew Diskin and Martin Shaw. In the pack, Mark Cox, Joel Nelson at nine, and Marvin Cox, Ryan Angus and Richard Moore in the second row, Aaron Gornall at loose forward. And on the bench for Leeds, Chris Fletcher, Andrew Billington, Martin Wood and Ewan Dowes. Steve Addy gets us underway at the Boulevard with Leeds kicking off through Richard Moore, and it's Faz Baluchi with the first touch for the Hull Sharks. Very much the underdogs, if you'll excuse the mixed metaphor, the Sharks in this one. But as we've mentioned, the Leeds teams, never mind whether it's Academy or the first team, Joe, don't like coming to the Boulevard.
Not many teams do. There's not much atmosphere as we speak, but things usually build up here. The pitch, I must say, is looking the best I've seen it for a long time. Probably the best I've ever seen it. Conditions are perfect for rugby league, but Leeds must start favourite despite the home team advantage.
And that's a good defensive set of six from the Leeds point of view, pinning Hull deep in their own territory, going for a 40-20 they were there, and still turned out to be a good kick because Mark Calderwood has had to chase back to field that ball, and he's fielded a posse of Hull Sharks as well.
Well, the Hull Sharks must be pleased with that one. Not only a good kick down, a good chase, but look at that, just pinning Leeds inside their own in goal area. And congratulations all round for the chasing team. A little bit of blood coming too from the head of Mark Calderwood.
So Hull making their enthusiasm quite evident right from the start. It's Jason Abdul who picks that ball up, and it's now with Chris Traynor. And Traynor, oh, after all that good work, the ball is lost.
Well, the first tackle really had to collect it. Looking at the defensive line, you would guess.
Stephen Holgate, the Hull Sharks Academy coach, taking charge of the youngsters while he recovers from a shoulder reconstruction. He'll be out for the remainder of the season, so he's keeping himself busy looking after the Hull Academy. That's Leeds' first possession, and they're winning their first penalty as well for offside, and Moore will take that very quickly indeed, Richard Moore. And Hull managed to regroup. Traynor with a tackle, Dean Bell looking on, impassive as ever, as Ryan Angus powers into that Hull line.
Well, two players from Hull going high, one needed to take the legs. They're making good yards now, Leeds, and that looks like the first try.
Joel Nelson it is. Nelson has got that ball over, and Nelson, who's taken over at number nine from Matthew Diskin, switched to standoff, and Nelson has got the first try for Leeds.
Well, Ryan Angus had made the inroads into the defence. People couldn't stop him, and then a quick play of the ball, and Joel Nelson, just a little scoot from acting halfback position, throws one dummy to the left and just gets over the try line. That's a great start from Leeds, but it was the run initially from Angus and then the dart from acting halfback after a quick play of the ball, and Leeds 4 points to the good.
So Richard Moore with his first attempt at goal, and has drilled that one across the face of the posts. And nevertheless, Leeds off to a good start, punishing Hull for that first error of the game. They lead by 4 points to nil. Jason Abdul with the restart for the Sharks, and Leeds almost getting into a tangle in their own in-goal area.
It's Ryan Angus, not the most conventional block of a ball.
Well, we've seen those punished before, haven't we? People just been a bit too casual.
Well, if the ball would have gone a little bit further forward, there was a good chance that Hull could have retain advantage of it and pick the ball up.
Leeds with their noses in front. This whole Sharks side, though, have been penalised again. Just trying to slow the play the ball down there.
Well, that's the fine line. That's two occasions now the whole Sharks have been pulled by the referee for the penalty. Most teams test early on the referee to just find out what the leeway is going to be.
Well, as the penalty count shows, it's not a lot with Steve Addy. Two penalties to Leeds already. They're on the halfway line with Marvin Cox now Shaw. Aaron Gornall. Gornall gets the ball away to Kirk. Kirk, a great pass to Danny Cook. Cook just tackled, and that'll be another penalty. And the referee just warning Chris Traynor there for flopping.
Coming in second man and slowing it down. Professional foul, really, just making sure that the Leeds Rhinos couldn't play the ball quickly.
Sinbinning.
There's a good chance on it that is early on, but that again, three penalties on the trot now against the Hull Sharks. And while they may have prevented the try being scored or a possible try, then they now have a chance. The Leeds Rhinos with a kick for goal from the penalty and a possible 2 points.
Richard Moore then with this penalty, and he's got the power, hasn't got the directions, and again he's found the corner. And just managing to stay in touch, in play rather, Johnny Woodcock. And I think the referee's given the scrum.
Well, it was just
the foot
right on the touchline.
Woodcock didn't agree with that, but the evidence was there, and Leeds have possession. Kirk has the ball, so the pressure on again. Hull backs to the wall. Shaw, good defence that time. Mark Moore in with the tackle. Ryan Angus stopped by Traynor. Shaw, Diskin, Kirk, good defence from Hull so far. But still up against it, Leeds looking to spread it out to the left. Diskin gets the ball back, and it's another try for Joel Nelson. Can't believe his luck. 16-year-old Joel Nelson, a newcomer to this Leeds Academy side, and he's got his second try already.
The Hull Sharks defensive line have moved up well, but weren't able to contain Matthew Diskin. He was able to offload in the tackle, and Joel Nelson on hand. Normally in the hooking role, Matthew Diskin stands up in the tackle, flicks a little pass out, and three Hull Sharks in the tackle. Couldn't stop Nelson from going over for his second try.
Well, take cover, because Richard Moore's been spraying them all over the place so far. And this one has got more height, and it's got more direction, and he's got the points as well. And it's looking ominous for Hull already. Hull 0, Leeds 10. Moore to Sean Cook. That pass a bit high, forcing Craig Farrell. And then Farrell has lost that ball under pressure from Glenn Donkin.
Well, it's a penalty. The referee's given the penalty. I think it was just for holding the player down, not letting him get it to his feet. Second effort. There it is.
So Glenn Donkin penalised, and then Donkin goes in high there. So this is a good spell for the Sharks, but can they make any use of it in terms of points?
Well, they're going sideways, they need to be more direct with the attack. I know this Leeds defence is strong, but they really have to start to run some straighter lines.
Elliott wrapped up in the tackle by Aaron Gornall. Moore, Sean Cook trying to step his way through. He's lost that ball, and the referee again has awarded a penalty.
Well,
to the Sharks.
I don't think that was a penalty either. Steve Addy was probably unsighted, but there was definitely an attempted pass in there rather than the ball being reefed out.
Craig Lawton, as the Sharks take that penalty quickly. spurning the chance of 2 points, looking for six. It's with the fullback Jason Abdul. He's got Richard Moore all over him. Moore's got to be careful. Mark Moore, that is, for the Sharks now. Oh, they've spilled that ball. Chris Traynor offloading it. And Darren Lilford couldn't take the pass. And Leeds bring it away. So the opportunity goes begging for the Sharks. Good defence, though. Again, Mark Moore in there. And the possession, well, Hull's shading it. Leeds have the points on the board, though. Shaw to Donkin. Couldn't find a way through there, just inside his own 40. And then Kirk Wisdom goes nowhere. That's the fifth tackle. That's more good work from the Sharks. And Shaw puts another deep kick in. Jason Abdul. Three Leeds players there to chase him, and Diskin gets him by the shorts. Johnny Woodcock with the run, Dean Bell busy making notes. Steve Kelly up to the Hull 30, and off goes Moore with a darting run. Moore has got through the first line of defence.
No support with him, though. Had half a look just over his shoulder to see if there was anybody. Made the right decision, just kept hold. And yet another penalty to Hull. Steve Addy calling the captain over, Diskin.
Richard Moore, the man penalised. Not so sure he wasn't hard done by there. But Steve Addy just laying down the law to the Leeds Rhinos captain, Matthew Diskin. More pressure from the Sharks now. Chris Traynor, willing worker in this first half hour. Plenty of enthusiasm from the Sharks as that ball comes out from the grasp of Chris Elliott and is picked up by Sean Cook, by Mark Moore, I beg your pardon, it was. Here's Jason Abdul, fancies his chances. Joel Nelson was in there, and it's Nelson who's got a bang to the throat, I think. He's still down. Meanwhile, Steve Kelly, I think it is. And just held up.
Did get the ball down. Diskin. Matthew Diskin, the captain. And Mark Calderwood preventing Hull from scoring the try.
So it's Hull's head and feet at this scrum. And this is an opportunity for them to get points on the board as half-time approaches. Leeds having to do the defending now. Kirk leading the way in that department. The ball goes out wide to Ian Bell. Bell held just short of that line. That's really the closest the Sharks have come. And again, Leeds close ranks. I think it was Moore trying to get his way over. Close range, but they're not getting anywhere. Cook, this time they go wide. Maybe an overlap here. Oh, they've lost that ball. Bellucci couldn't take it. Appeals to the referee. But Leeds certainly having to do some work on their own line at the moment.
Well, Hull have got the pressure on the Leeds line, but they just need the angle runners. They need somebody coming back on the inside to hold the slide defence up. They're not really making the Leeds Rhinos defence think. They're just taking the man for man, and it's quite simple for them. They've had to work hard, but it's not taxing on the brain. They know that exactly where the Hull Sharks are going to run.
Shaw trying to step his way through. Moore just got a tap to him. And then the tackle is completed by Chris Elliott. That's the fifth tackle. Moore with a big boot. Jason Abdul had plenty of work to do in this first half. Runs it back and again runs into Shaw and Mark Cox. Chris Traynor. Cox chases him. Gornall there as well. Good run from Craig Farrell. Now Mark Moore again. Impressive first half from the hooker.
He's had a top first half in defence and attack. He's made some good snapping runs from the acting half-back position. His defence has been superb. Stopping.
Then Hull come up with the error again and lose possession. And there's a Hull player down. I think it's Sean Cook.
Well, they ran into Joel Nelson. Nelson stood his ground. You don't have to move, but he made contact with number seven. Nelson making sure that his elbows were down.
Touch judges on to discuss the incident with the referee. And again, Stephen Addy's having a conversation with Matthew Diskin. He's been on pretty good terms by now.
It's probably the third occasion that he's asked the Leeds captain to come out for a quiet chat, lay the law down.
Well, as Joe was saying at the start, it's always a tough one at the Boulevard, and they're not disappointing. Joel Nelson, who's had an eventful first 40 minutes, two tries. And involved in that incident. And the penalty goes the Sharks' way. So they can't complain about lack of opportunity in this first 40 minutes. They've had the majority of the possession. Since going 10-0 down, they really seem to have spent most of the half in the Leeds half. All they've got to do is find a way through this Leeds defence. Craig Lawton trying to do that. Moore, off he goes again, this hooker. He's on trial with the Hull Sharks at the moment, but my word, he must be making a good impression here. In goes Sean Cook. Cook very close to that line.
Well, he's held up, he can't get across. He's the one that got the penalty, Sean Cook, in the first place when Nelson made contact after the chip, and he almost got the try for the Hull Sharks. They got over the line but couldn't get it down. Good defence from Leeds. Danny Cook holding up Sean Cook.
16-year-old brother of Paul Cook, who's involved in the Sharks' first team at the moment. And here is Sean Cook again. Cook to Chris Elliott, right in front of those posts now. Moore, Steve Kelly, Bellucci, trying to wrestle his way out of the grip of Mark Cox. Moore, here's Elliott. Elliott changes direction. He's trying to get over that line. He's still going. The referee calls held. But just short of the line now. Moore will go on his own. He's short of the line.
Inches short.
Now they move the ball wide. Sean Cook. Cook puts the little chip kick through, and Kirk Wisdom is there. And Wisdom
pushed back over his own try line.
He is.
Well, they can't score. They can't get across the line with the ball in the hand, but on this occasion they put the kick in. And while Kirk Wisdom collects, four players eventually.
Moore's drop out from under the posts, picked up by Chris Elliott now. Elliott puts the shoulder into Andy Kirk. Diskin is there as well. Diskin leading the tackling for his side. This time it's Darren Lilford, the man tackled. Moore, Cook, Chris Traynor. Three tackles gone for the Sharks. Cook. Craig Cook, no relation. little chip kick from Sean Cook, but Diskin read that one well.
Oh, two smaller kicks. It was no real problems for them. They just had to collect it. Diskin, it was the captain that made sure of he tied it up behind the line. And as we approach the half-time interval again, Hull have spent probably the majority of the last 20 minutes in Leeds half of the field, but have failed to capitalise on that possession and that territory. Still the big zero on the scoreboard for the Hull Sharks. And 10 points to Leeds. They give a penalty away now and give Leeds the chance to venture into the Hull half, probably for the first time in quite a few minutes.
And this time it's the Sharks captain Craig Farrell who's having a chat with the referee. And then Richard Moore blasts that one with his howitzer-like left boot.
Straight past the ear of Steve Addy too. I think the referee thought he was going to lose his head then.
So now it's the Sharks' turn to defend. And Leeds come at them again. And oh, if they could have picked that ball up. The break was on there for the Sharks. As it is, that's the end of the first 40 minutes. And Dean Bell will be reasonably happy with that first 40 minutes. Certainly with the scoreline, 10 points to nil. Joel Nelson, two tries, putting Leeds in front. There's just 10 points in it. Leeds ahead at the moment, but they know they're in for a battle in this second half. Hull have made that perfectly clear. And the first penalty of this second half immediately goes to Leeds. Again, Hull flopping on in the tackle. So Leeds get the penalty. Mark Cox it is in possession. The penalty count, well, it's even now. It started off heavily in Leeds' advantage, and then Hull went in front on that score, and now Leeds have come back, and it's seven penalties apiece. Referee Stephen Addy really hasn't had time for any infringements at the play the ball or around the tackle. Cox, Mark Cox, that is, up to halfway. Dean Bell.
Well, Dean watching on there, you would expect him to say, listen, we need to spend a little bit more time in the opposition's half of the field. Let's get down there. And they do this on this occasion through the kick. Will it hold up in goal?
Well, Jason Abdul wasn't going to take any chances.
But I'm sure that was the message at halftime by Dean Bell, the Leeds Rhinos academy coach. He just said, let's spend at least 50-50 down in their half of the field. Let's put some pressure on them, because they really had to absorb an awful lot of pressure from the Hull Sharks in that first half. They managed to keep the scoreline reading zero and 10 points in their favour. But it must have taken an awful lot out of them.
Well, it's never an easy ground, this one, and Leeds know that from the Academy Championship last year. They lost 18-9 here. Stephen Holgate, the Sharks coach, will probably have reminded his side of that, that last year's Academy side managed to beat the Leeds Rhinos here. But it's Leeds in possession now with Diskin. Diskin to Ryan Angus. Nice. Angus is tackled. Diskin will go himself. Has he got that ball down? And Diskin showing that he can do exactly what his deputy as hooker Joel Nelson can do. Short range try. And Matthew Diskin, the captain, gets Leeds off to the sort of start they wanted in this second half.
Matthew Diskin, as captain, goes to his customary role of acting halfback, takes it on the short side and just catches the Hull Sharks unaware. Explosive pace from that pickup. And they just couldn't react quick enough, the Hull Sharks. And the first try for Leeds Rhino in the second half from the captain, Matthew Diskin.
Richard Moore with one success from his three attempts at goal. Again, he's got good height, but hasn't got the direction. Pushed it across the face of the posts. But Leeds now ahead by 14 points to nil. Leeds probably breathing a little easier now, having got that try under their belts early on in the second half, just as they wanted.
But that's how they started the first half, scoring points early, and then the Hull Sharks put the pressure on to close the first half. And a mistake. Glenn Donkey putting the ball down, and it's given Hull the opportunity inside the Leeds 20.
Exactly what the Sharks were looking for, forcing the error. And now can they make anything of it? Had so much possession in the second half of that first half and couldn't do anything with it. Steve Kelly now. Mark Moore, outstanding in the first half. Cook, Balucci. Draws three defenders to him but can't offload that ball.
And although he didn't put the pass in, it was good to see runners either side of him.
Off goes Mark Moore. Moore will go himself. This time it looks as though they have got over that line. And Mark Moore has got the try. My word, he's earned that.
Confirmation from Steve Addy. He has earned it. He's had a great first half and he started the second half with a try that puts Hull right back in this game. Rather like Matthew Diskin a few minutes earlier. The pick-up from the acting halfback down the short side and the dummy as well. And cut this occasion, catches Leeds napping. A little dummy, well played. Great little run. And a try that puts Hull back in this one, gives them a lot of confidence now into the second half.
Steve Kelly then has this difficult conversion from wide out on the Sharks' left. Two more points here would be very welcome indeed for the Sharks and give them hope that they can overhaul the Rhinos. Kelly has swung that one in beautifully. That is what the Sharks wanted. Hull 6, Leeds 14. Big hanging restart from Richard Moore, but Kelly was underneath it, and that'll put a spring in this whole step.
And again, just that little angle run there, the little inside dummy runner, just takes a little bit of pressure off, and Hull has started to make yardage from acting halfback and also first receiver.
The ball went backwards from Craig Lawton.
Popped out, it was Diskin that made the tackle, but Hull able to collect again.
And the referee has wiped the tackle count clean, back to six for Hull. It was back to six, two gone. But definite scent for the Sharks here. Oh, that was hanging very temptingly for Andy Kirk. Johnny Woodcock just managing to stay in play. Calderwood with the tackle. Mark Calderwood, 14 tries this season, hasn't had a hint of a chance. And then Cook puts a poor kick in, out on the full.
Half a metre too far, good distance, too much distance in fact.
Stephen Holgate must be pretty proud of the effort his academy side has put in. Leeds get the head and feet at that scrum because it was on the fourth tackle kicked. So now it's Leeds with Ryan Angus and now with Mark Cox. Mark Moore again there. Marvin Cox now. Gets to his feet and is then driven back by Chris Elliott. Shaw, Richard Moore. Moore finds a gaping hole in that whole line. and needs no second invitation to exploit it. Simple as you like from big Richard Moore. Steaming onto that pass and the perfect response from Leeds to that whole try.
Straight back down the middle of the ruck for the big 17-year-old. Manages to get outside the tackle two of Jason Abdul, the last line of defence. Nice little offload, the inside pass from Martin Shaw. And then Richard Moore has all the strength and speed to cross the line. Switch of play behind the play of the ball, and then a huge gap down the middle. And size and speed takes its toll on the whole line.
And Moore has the opportunity to convert his own try. Hasn't got his kicking boots on today. He's pushed that one wide as well, but Leeds now 18 points to 6 in front. First touch for Ewan Dowes, one of the two players being given their chance in this game for Leeds by the Leeds coach Dean Bell. Ewan Dowes just left Sedbergh School in North Yorkshire and a rugby union player normally, but he's having a trial with Leeds Rhinos at the moment. There's Chris Fletcher, also off the bench. Diskin, good ball out wide. This could be another try for Moore. It will be. Richard Moore, just the right distance from him, no stopping him. And suddenly, Leeds taking a grip on this game.
Experience telling Matthew Diskin in the standoff role, delays the pass, and it is a good one across the front of two Hull Sharks players. The little hidden spin from Richard Moore puts him across the line, but watch the pass from Diskin, flat and at speed, takes out two players, Hull defence, and then the hit can't keep Richard Moore from scoring the try. The flat pass, the handle runner, dummy runner, gets across the front of two Hull defenders with a nice flat ball of the pass, and then Moore has enough power to cross the line for the try, and again Leeds extend that lead and look in control.
Well, Ryan Angus has taken over kicking duties now. His turn to see whether he can add two more points. And the rangefinder not yet locked on, but Leeds moving out of range, 22 points to 6 ahead now. So the Sharks must have felt there was a hint of a chance of them getting back into this game, but Leeds have pretty thoroughly dispelled that notion, haven't they, Joe?
Well, they've done well, though, the Hull Sharks. They've come into this game with so many injuries, so many players missing. They showed a lot of character and a lot of determination. And the clock, the scoreboard is against them, but I think they can still come back into this game. There is time. They just need to try.
Certainly is a chance if Leeds keep coming up with errors like that one from Aaron Gornall, letting the ball slip. And it's now with Chris Elliott on the 10, just in front of those Leeds posts. Sharks looking a bit static. It's with Martin Osler, but he's lost the ball and it's picked up by Mark Calderwood. Calderwood not tackled, says the referee. That was the incident where the ball was lost. And the referee has finally, I think, run out of patience, and I think he's run out of patience with Chris Traynor. And he's gone to the sin bin.
Well, this is the incident that cost the Hull Sharks one of their players.
Diskin, here's Ewan Dowes again. And that's good offload from Dowes back to Diskin. And Dowes finds the ball again. I don't think he was quite expecting that. I don't think Martin Shaw was welcoming that. Should have hung on to that one. Goes Mark Moore. That's a good tackle though from Andrew Billington. That's his first involvement in the game. Craig Cook. And then it was Craig Lawton. Well, and the referee's going for his pocket again, well, and he's going to even things up. Well, yep. What an introduction.
Ewan Dowes on the field. He was offside at the play of the ball, and the referee decided that that would probably have been a try, I think, if he could have got away clearly offside and got back in the defensive line or up marker.
Well, I think that was unfortunate for Ewan Dowes, because in his first game, I think that was probably inexperience. But it's a harsh life. It's even scored the sides up now, 12 apiece, and the Sharks threatening again with Chris Elliott. Off goes Mark Moore again. Moore looking for his second try.
He really has impressed me, the hooker on trial here at the Boulevard this afternoon, but he's done everything right, including scoring a try. Now let's see if Hull can score another one.
Sean Cook, Cook is through! Another try for Hull. They haven't given up hope yet. Sean Cook got there, Leeds let him slip. And 16-year-old Sean Cook has gone in for the try.
They didn't seem that much on for the Hull Sharks, with a good flat defensive line by the Leeds Rhinos, but it was a missed tackle in the end. Danny Cook couldn't take Sean Cook. Too many Cooks boil the broth. I don't know what it was, but he missed the tackle, definitely. And in the end, it was an easy try. Not many options open outside him, but as soon as that first line was breached, particularly seeing as the fullback was the one that missed the tackle, then there was nobody to try and stop Sean Cook.
He is one of three Cooks on the pitch. Not too many Cooks as far as Hull Sharks are concerned, because that try has given Steve Kelly this conversion opportunity. Another tricky one. Kelly has pushed that one across the face of the posts. Looks disappointed. Hull 10, Leeds 22. So they won't lie down, this Hull side. Leeds certainly not comfortably in command of this game yet. 12 points the difference. And still 16 minutes to go.
Well, two quick tries from Hull. And Hull could snatch this one. And here's the first chance too.
It's Kelly on the break. Across comes Cook. Away goes Ian Bell. Bell will aim for the corner. He's going to do better than that, Ian Bell. And 16-year-old Ian Bell has given Hull Sharks something to cheer about. Getting away down that right-hand side. Steve Kelly with the break. Bell finished it off.
Great backline move from the Hull Sharks. Good handling. Again, a dummy runner. We didn't see much of it in the first half. And on the outside, Ian Bell, the wingman, using the touchline as his friend, manages to stay in and also improve the angle for the kick. Slams the ball down with one hand. I'm sure Stephen Holgate, the Hull Sharks coach, would have liked to have seen it to put down with two, but a good try from Hull. Good speed, gets away, can't be stopped, and comes in to improve the angle and get near the post. And Hull are right back in this one. They celebrate.
Well, Steve Kelly missed the previous conversion from just about the identical spot. This one may be a little bit closer to the posts. This time he's got it right. Two more precious points for the Sharks. This one isn't over yet. Stephen Holgate, the academy coach, telling his lads that there's just one try in it now. Hull 16, Leeds 22. Dean Bell looks on philosophically, I think. On the last, Moore puts the kick in, and Mark Calderwood is back there. Good chase though from Jason Abdul. And then the penalty is given, and that's a shame for Jason Abdul. He He got there well.
Well, I'm trying to look at what the decision was, whether it was offside or whether the referee had shouted held in the tackle. Well, if he wasn't offside, that was one-on-one. The tackle wasn't completed, in my opinion. And I think Jason Abdul and the whole Sharks are a little bit upset with that, because that was a great opportunity. If they could have taken that ball right under the Leeds Rhinos post, they could have had another chance to attack them.
Well, meanwhile, Richard Moore has unleashed the most amazing penalty kick from inside his own 10 to right on the Sharks' 30-metre line. Some kick, and it's totally turned the tables now and put Leeds in a very strong position. So the Sharks can probably feel a little bit hard done by as Diskin goes in looking for his second, and he's just short of that line. Glenn Donkin trying to get over. Donkin thinks he's got that ball down.
And he has.
And the referee agrees.
Well, that's a signal for the Hull Sharks Academy, because they were right under the lead sticks. And then with one mistake, a penalty, a huge kick, and a couple of play the balls, they find themselves collected underneath their own posts and a try being scored against them.
Glenn Donkin signed from the Hull area by Leeds, goes over for the try, but this was the incident at the other end.
Well, I don't think the tackle had been completed there. He manages to steal the ball. And this is a try again, just short yardage, nothing fancy.
Goal kicking has been a bit of a problem for the Rhinos Academy today. Could have made life a lot easier for themselves if they'd taken these extra points, and they've blown another two there. Ryan Angus pushing that one wide. Hull 16, Leeds 26. Kelly this time hoists the big kick, and there's a good chase from Hull there, but it's come up for the Rhinos. It's Diskin who's got the ball. It was, I think, Andy Kirk who just got a touch to it to knock it back. Here's the try scorer, Glenn Donkin. Former West Hull player. You'll know one or two of his opponents today. Mark Calderwood with the run. It really hasn't been a winger's game though, has it, Joe? I mean, interestingly, I think just one of the tries has been scored by a winger, by Ian Bell.
And not many of them from long range either.
Hull have come up with that ball now. A Leeds player is down injured, but Hull carry on, the game carries on. It's Martin Shaw, I think, who's taken a knock to the ankle. He's down and out of action, so Hull will come again, and it's with Martin Osler just inside that Leeds 10, and they really won't give this one up, will the Sharks?
Diskin scrambling back on that occasion. They go again to the right this time. They have the numbers.
They've got the numbers. Have they got the points? It's Craig Farrell. Farrell is in. He's somehow got through those Leeds tacklers. And Hull have come back again. It's the captain, Craig Farrell, with that try.
The young Sharks hit back almost immediately. The ball going back along the back line to the right-hand side. The captain, Craig Farrell, coming in straight and hard. And the Leeds Rhinos players can't prevent him from scoring the try. They're Leeds on the slide. And it's a straight angle run that causes a problem. Back in at the angle. Danny Cook's the substitute's the Fletcher, but they can't prevent the captain Farrell from scoring the try. Five Hull players, the huge gap, the step at the end, and as the Leeds Rhinos get there, he just gets to the line for the try.
This is a big kick for Steve Kelly. It should be two extra points. It's again, a little bit closer than his last successful attempt, and he's pushed it wide. He was just a bit too casual with that one. And Kelly shakes his head. It's Hull 20, Leeds 26. Sean Cook will surely hoist this ball. They're running it. Craig Farrell. Farrell can't get away, and probably the wrong option. And the last option as well for the Sharks. But what a great game between these two sides. They haven't disappointed again, and Hull might be struggling at the wrong end of the table, but they really have given the Rhinos a run for their money. So Leeds Rhinos just squeezing home by 26 points to 20. Hull's try scorers Moore, Cook, Bell and Farrell, two goals from Kelly. For Leeds, two apiece from Nelson and Moore, one each for Diskin and Donkin, one success for the boot of Richard Moore. The full results then from the Academy League this week: Bradford 28, Warrington 34, Huddersfield 52, Salford City 16, Hull 20, Leeds 26, London 10, Wakefield 24, Sheffield 4, St Helens 46, Widnes 16, Castleford 22, Wigan 32, Halifax 16. So Bradford Bulls remain on top of the table despite losing at home to the Wolves, but they're level on points now, 26 apiece. Also on 26, the Leeds Rhinos. The Bulls ahead on the narrowest of points differences. Then comes St Helens in fourth place and Castleford Tigers in fifth, with Wigan Warriors and Huddersfield Giants just outside the top five. That's it from the Academy League this week. We're back with Super League Live